Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. I know nobody watches my show anymore because Facebook blocks me, but that's okay. Because really, start rolling now. Facebook doesn't affect me, and I will reach my people, God's people, in other ways. So I'm not worried. But wanted to share a word with you. It's from Amos, and it was pretty bad, so I'm not sure if it's for you. Whoever's going to come watch this, you're going to get a bad message, and I'm sorry. But I'm about to run out of gas. I'm trying to make it to the gas station before I run out. 331 miles to the tank. Super duper low. But I still see yellow. I mean, I still see white underneath that stick there, so I'm gonna go with I still have gas in the car. If that thing ain't, it moved. Well, if it's not all the way down, then there's still gas in it. And the gas station that pumps your gas is just right up here. Look at my hair. I'm like a freaking chia pet or something. What is going on? This looks crazy. Good morning. Good morning. So I was reading Amos this morning, and quite interesting, things that were quite interesting was God's going, I kept the rain from you, I brought locusts to you, I burned this up, I cut you off, I shut you down. He did all this stuff to us, to certain people, not me. Well, yeah, he has done things to me as well. But they did not turn. The Israelites did not turn back to God. They did not turn back to God. And he did some other bad stuff to them. And he took their children, you know, firstborn and things like that. Did not turn back to God. Did not. But unfortunately, there's no more time left. We've done run out of time. And those who are going to be found in their sin are not going to be so happy. It's going to be ugly, 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 ugly time for you. So, I know that I always say this. And maybe you just don't know how to do it because I know it's hard to walk away from sin. I know it's hard. Girl, I'm the queen of sin. Boom. But, I am more afraid of God than I enjoy my sin. Let me say that again. I am more afraid of God than I enjoy my sin. Okay, so whatever your sin might be drinking. All right, you're going to have fun for maybe 3 hours. All right, 3 hours of fun. Whew. If you knew, you probably, the reason is you don't know God. And I know God. See, my problem is I know God, but I don't really know Jesus. I don't get Jesus. I don't get how he could just love you for just no reason. Because God's like, dude, I'm going to destroy you. You better come back to me. I am everything that you need. You better get back over here. And we're like, yeah, nah. And he's just like, all right. He gives you a bunch of bow-bows, like mad bow-bows too. Still, we're just like, yeah, I'm good. I'm good. I'm over here. I'm just going to do this over here. But why is that? Like, nobody wants to get beat on. Nobody wants to, you know, have tough times. Why do we do it? Are the sins that good? No! They're really not, are they? I mean, really? What are they? They're really not. Are you having a little sex? Ooh, it's so much fun. It's really not, all right? It's really not. It's like maybe 20 hour worth of good stuff. It's like, just... You know, if you're married, then good for you. Then have sex, because I know a lot of married people out there aren't having sex, and the freaking single people are having sex with people they're not supposed to be having sex with. So, yeah, have sex with your spouse. Because if I had a spouse, I'd be having sex with them all the time. Probably not, but enough times to make us both happy, okay? But it's not really worth it. Like, look. Let's just put it this way. You ever see somebody, a human being getting burned to death? Have you ever seen that? I actually saw a video of a girl. She got beat up by her family. She was in a circle, like 12-year-old girl. Don't forget the gas, Diane. Do not pass the gas station, seriously, because I'm talking to you guys. That would be detrimental. I think it's just right up here, too. Boop, 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 boop. Well, she got burns because she wanted to be a Christian and they were Muslim. They put her in a circle. They pushed her all around. They were stoning her, throwing stones at her and everything. And then, boom, lit her on fire. And she died within a matter of, I don't know, 6 or 7 minutes. If that. She died pretty fast, I thought. That morning. Hi, Chris. I know this is pretty sick for morning talk, but I'm trying to make a point here. So she died pretty fast, but she was screaming. And you ever burn your hand, burn your arm in the oven and it has that bubble? That hurts, man. That hurts. It's like a weird pain, but that hurts so bad when it opens up. When the skin tears away from the blister. Whoo, mama, you see stars with that blister. So can you imagine eternity? You're just burning like on a freaking pit stick, like a pit hog. Someone's turning and your skin is burning and burning and burning. And all you can do is sit there and take it. Because he's warned you. He's told you many a times. I've told you. Other people have told you. Your pastor told you. Your parents told you. You know the truth. Everybody knows the truth of God. Hell is real. You only get there with Jesus. And the choice is yours. And that is where we mess up. If we did not have free will, we would be safe in God's arms. We would be fine. But because he gives us free will, we make the wrong daggone decision. Why on earth would we choose something besides God? Like, now that I'm actually literally thinking about it, it makes absolutely no sense. But just yesterday, I'm like, hey, what's up? Anybody want to go to the bar? I'm bored. You know what I mean? It's like, but just because I go to the bar doesn't mean which side's the gas tank on? The right side? Hold on. I have to figure out which side the gas tank is on. I made it to the gas tank.
I made it to the gas station.
$2.95. That's cheaper than Wawa. Good job. Okay, where'd that money go? Okay. So now I can actually talk to everyone who's left. So, what is it that makes sin so appealing? Maybe we just lose ourselves. Because it's kind of like, how on earth did I get here? Where's the guy? Come on. Hello? Peep out my gas, please. The reason I came here is because I want my gas pumped, please. So anyway. So this is a plus. This is a blessing. See what I mean? When you are on God's side, on God's page, you're doing what he wants you to, you're helping others, you're living for other people instead of just yourself, you're spreading the word of God, he will bless you with the tiniest things like $2.95 gas that somebody eventually is going to pump here for me. Yes, yeah, see, eventually. It's a blessing because it is cold outside and Wawa's $2.95. Hi, 20 regular, please. Okay, I hold the money. Oh, yeah. I gotta open the latch. That's a pain in the neck. Hey, you wanna get a little closer to my car there, buddy? I wonder when this crashed on your car. Okay. So that's that. So today's assignment, Chris, if you have your notebook, I want you to write down what your sins are. And then what makes them so appealing. Like, why do you write, like, what's so great about going to the bar, my friend Doug? He's like 75. No, he's 70. Good conversation. A lot of laughs. That's enough for me, I guess. But, see, the thing is, when I go and I hang out with Doug, I don't get all sloppy drunk anymore. I used to. We tear him down. And then come home and scream at my kid, and I don't do that anymore. I have two, and we're done. So, You missed the whole thing. The end is near. Look at your life. Figure out what your sin is and why you like it so much. And then you can maybe attack it. So one, I've gotten rid of. The bar thing, I've gotten control of. And the cursing, I'm aware of. So, stop. So that's that. So, that's my blessing. 5 cents, thank you. 4 cents savings on gas. That is pumped by somebody else. So that's what I was saying. God blesses us in tiny ways because that's like, I don't know, 20 bucks. I got half a tank. Oy vey. So, my kid, I put $20. He got $20 for his birthday from my friend, right? And he puts it to, he bought something with it, so I had the cash. And I was like, all right, I'm going to put this here in this little cup in the kitchen for emergency money. He's like, okay, so I go out to the car. I'm like, oh, crap, I don't have any gas. And so I run back in the house, and he's like, hi. I was like, hi. And I take the money. He goes, oh, so much for emergency money. I said, it's an emergency. I don't have any money. Oh, that was hilarious. It was an emergency. I don't have any money. Duh, why the heck? But then later on, Doug's going to be like, oh, you're going to come to the bar. And I'm like, well, I have $19 left. I have $19 left to my name, but I have to buy lunch today, too, for probably six, so I can't go to the bar with less than $8. You get, well, actually, you can, because you get two $3 drinks at six, and two is, yeah, you're perfect. $8 is enough, if you're an alcoholic, so. Actually, there's a place in, like, all the way down in Feasterville that's $2.50 for a beer. But then you're paying for gas because it is kind of far, and then you're taking all sorts of risks. But you're only having two or three beers anyway, so you're really not in any danger of anything. But if you have a drinking problem, please seek help. let's hear some music, guys. There's nobody here. Who's there? Oh, hi, Danny. Hi, Kevin. Hi, Chris. Nobody watches me. What do we got?
I'm seeing my life for the very first time, do it differently.
There you go.
Yesterday.
Let's hear this one.
I didn't understand.
Drive with me.
Driving 35 with a rocket inside, didn't know what I had. While I've been waiting to live, my life's been
my life. Know I will. You guys know that I believe in Jesus. Jesus so much that I'm going to try the hardest thing that I could possibly do, and you're going to see how Jesus can do anything. If you got the right intentions, if you got the right heart, he will take you where you want to go. And I'm going to be living proof of that. So if you want to watch that, you can stay tuned on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. All over. I'm going to be all over because I'm going to be spreading the word of God everywhere, 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 everywhere. Say that I will. My name is Diana. This is Winning with Jesus. And remember, be blessed and be a blessing. Thanks for watching.